So continuing our little superimposing adventure, what I do here is, as opposed to what I did the other day, where I sent you a video where I was playing also a pentatonic lick, but I played it in D minor, giving us the flattened sixth in our pentatonic lick. This time I move it to something as crazy as G, giving us a flattened ninth. But the remaining notes pertains also to the natural minor and the harmonic minor. So what happens is, just when I go into my kick-ass legato lick, I get the sound also from the flattened ninth, which again kind of makes us sit on the edge of the chair, saying, what the hell is happening? And then we get back home safe into the minor, the A minor scale, which is with the feeling that you want to give your audience, or your family, or whoever is listening, or just yourself, as what I'm doing here. So what I do is, I have my lick, I have my pentatonic lick. So again, as I talked about yesterday, or in the previous video, it's not about playing a particular lick. Again, it happened, what I'm talking about is, instead of just, not that there's anything wrong with that, playing the scale up and down, I take a lick that I already know that this sounds awesome, but instead of getting the typical sound of staying in key, I move into another key, which is the superimposing part, and in this magical way I get an additional sound to the lick that I already know. So the awesome thing about this is, I play something that I already know, I don't have to practice a new lick. I get the sound from the pentatonic, but just by moving it about around a little bit, I get, for free, I get a new sound. And then, of course, also the bonus effect is that once you finish your lick and you go back into the regular key, in this case the A minor, I get that wonderful feeling of feeling home and safe again. So that's what I'm doing here. But this time, instead of playing it in D, I move it into the G. Let me just show you and take a little bit of that noisy distortion off. So, you know, I play my pentatonic from here. And again, as I talked about yesterday, you can also just play something that you know and that you think already sounds nice at this point. If it's something like that, that's fine. Something bluesy, just like that. And you can move that around and get a new sound. So if I'm here, I can move it down to the G. Just make sure you go back into the key that you're in. That's the idea. So, before I did it in D, now I do it in G. What I did was that I have my lick from here, so I start from the A string instead, and that's not really the issue, or that's not what it's about. It doesn't matter. So if you just have something that you know fits to that first pattern, you can just move that around. So in the what I'm talking about is G. Then so if my lick is here, then I go down here and play it with the same lick, and if I enjoy that lick, of course. And then I go back again to A. And in this magical way, I get also the flat ninth, and I get back home safe again in A minor. That's the idea. So again, like yesterday or the previous video, you can download that kick-ass backing track, very simple backing track. The backing track, remember, it's not to necessarily inspire you to soloing, it's for you to practice this concept. So it's just an A minor, this one, but you can download it under the video.